This video covers prerequisites, installation, configuration, and testing of the ServiceNow ODBC driver. Link time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. The ServiceNow ODBC driver provides read-only access to the database associated with your ServiceNow instance. You cannot modify instance data through ODBC, and it isn't intended to copy large amounts of data at a time. But it's very useful for reporting and other purposes. We must carry out some prerequisites before installing the ODBC driver. We'll review these briefly. The ODBC driver requires the Java runtime environment, so install the JRE or Java Development Kit if it's not already present on the machine where the ODBC driver is to be installed. We've already installed it, as we see here. Next, check the machine to determine if its operating system is 32 or 64-bit. Ours is 64-bit. If your operating system is 64-bit, also check the bit level of the application to be used with the ODBC driver. For example, Microsoft Excel. Many applications are 32-bit. If that's the case with yours, you'll need to use the 32-bit driver. Next, review the requirements in the product docs and make sure the installation machine meets them. When you're ready, download the appropriate ODBC driver from this KB article in HI. The user account that ODBC uses to log into and query the instance must have the ODBC role, which is available in the base system. Here, we're logged into our ServiceNow instance as a user with the admin role, which is required to create user accounts and assign roles. We've already created a user account, ODBC user, which we'll use for ODBC login. Special characters in the user ID may interfere with queries, so make sure this field contains only letters, numbers, and underscores. We give our user the ODBC role, which adds several other inherited roles, including SOAP query, allowing the user to send SOAP requests, and ITIL, which gives the user access to all task tables. Here are some final things to check before installing the ODBC driver. Validate that the ODBC login user can log into the ServiceNow instance. Make sure your network firewall doesn't block the connection. If it does, work with your network team to resolve the issue. Now we're ready to install the ODBC driver. We've already downloaded it, so let's run it. This is really important. Make sure you run it as administrator, even if you have admin privileges. First-time installation requires running the software only once, but upgrades require running it twice. Once to uninstall the previously installed version, and again to install the upgrade. Ours is a first-time installation, but if you're upgrading, you'll be prompted to uninstall first. And when that finishes, you'll rerun the software and end up here. We accept the terms, and here we click Next to accept the default values. Now we need to provide the location of our Java virtual machine, and these instructions provide guidance. It's in the JRE home folder, bin server subfolder. These defaults are fine, so we'll just click through them. Now we're finished with the installation, so we move on to configuration, which we accomplish through the ServiceNow ODBC management console. We run it as administrator. The main thing to configure is pointing the ODBC driver to our instance. By setting the data source IP properties value to our instance URL. So let's copy that from the browser, making sure to get only the domain name part. Paste it here, and save it. There's one final configuration task. If you connect to your instance by proxy, configure the proxy settings for the ODBC driver. We won't go into that here, it's explained in the product docs. Now, to test the connection, we navigate to the ODBC Data Source Administrator. Normally, this will be available in the Start menu, but if you don't find it there, just search for it. Our driver is 64-bit, so we'll run the 64-bit ODBC Data Source Administrator. Here, on the System DSN tab, is our data source, which we double-click to initiate a test connection. Then we provide the username and password that ODBC will use to log into our ServiceNow instance. Ours is the ODBC user we configured with the ODBC role. And this means we connected successfully, but it doesn't guarantee that we can run queries. So we'll run a test query to verify that the user has the rights to send requests to the instance via ODBC and the expected results are returned. To save time, we'll run a test query that will return just one record. In our instance, let's copy an incident number to the clipboard to use in the query. We'll also make a mental note of the short description, which we'll request in our query. Now we open an interactive SQL window for ODBC, connect to the ServiceNow instance, and type our query at the prompt, pasting the incident number we copied earlier. Here are the results, and as expected, it returned just that one record. Our ODBC installation is working fine. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.